Michael Washagrud, a Jewish scholar, I just love to read his stuff because you really get a greater insight into what Paul was up against when you read some of these modern Jewish scholars, because they're the same arguments. And Washagrud has read Paul better than most Protestants. Mm-hmm. He says, first of all, it seems to me, here's the basic argument. Paul thinks that Israel can be defined by a secret election that is invisible. We believe that Israel can only be defined by an open public election that is totally visible and physical, engraved in the very body. The move, he says, Paul makes is to identify that election with Christ. It is his body and not the physical body of Israel as an ethnic people.
Wow.
Just brilliant. That he really gets it, and he helped me to understand Paul a little bit better. But what's interesting is Washagrud, at the end of it all, he says, a Jew can never accept this spiritualized election. We can never accept that it had nothing to do with our merits, or that it had nothing to do with our ethnic coherence as a people. Mm. It is always this nation and no other nation that God has in mind when he talks about election. Wow, he gets Paul better than most Protestant interpreters.
Yeah, that raises a gazillion questions. I think one of the things that in our tradition, I know, Rod, you have it as well, are the Manchester Reformers all worried about a Jewish interpretation of Scripture. And they accused the
I worry about Protestant interpretation. They
were basically saying that the promises of material blessing and prosperity, i.e. an earthly millennium, are fanatical because those are read through the lens of Jewish eyes, not Christian eyes, and that Christians were looking for a heavenly city, not an earthly millennium. And so that's why our guys didn't like Killeyism in any way, shape, or form.
Millennialism,
because it saw heavenly promises with earthly fulfillment. So our guys all condemned that. Sadly, a lot of our people then read that through kind of the late medieval anti-Semitic lens, mm-hmm. and tied that to an ethnic hatred of Jews because they were ethnically Jewish.
Mm-hmm.
And
which is the reverse of this
which
problem.
Which is the reverse of this problem. And we have to say, on the one hand, while we must reject out of hand a Jewish interpretation of Scripture because it is not Christocentric, while we do that, we have to turn right around and be very, very clear that anti-Semitism on a racial basis is mm-hmm. also condemned by that same Christocentric hermeneutic. Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Absolutely. Yeah.
That's right.
And we're not clear on the latter half, because our Jewish friends get real nervous.
So no one is elect because they're ethnically Jewish.
Absolutely.
And no one is
condemned
because they're ethnically Jewish.
Absolutely.
That's isn't any longer
huge
about
point.
About that.
Theology.
In fact, it never has been.
Yeah.